That I've learned in life is that when you lead, people truly do follow.
We don't understand sometimes that when one man stands, it inspires others. You cannot lead from the rear, you must lead from the front. You must hold the line. You do not compromise, you do not fear the enemy. See, the Lord said that He has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of strength and of a sound mind.
We as men were made for battle. We were created for battle. We are soldiers in the army of God, and we have one purpose, and that is to take the gospel to all of Sudan and all of Africa, and as far as the Lord will permit us to take the gospel to the world, that is our aim, our goal, and our one desire in life. We train our guys, we train them hard. They don't have an easy life over there. We get them up at 5 o'clock in the morning, we run them for 8 miles, we have 8 hours of class time, 2.5 hours of study time, and they get 2 meals a day of beans and rice. They get meat about once every 2 weeks, and they get vegetables occasionally. And we don't do it because we can't feed them better, we could, but we know that if we train them softly, when they get to the front lines, they will not survive. Where planets are in motion and galaxies are bright. We are amazed in the light of the stars. It's all proclaiming who you are. You're beautiful. Men were never supposed to run from battle. We were supposed to stand and we were supposed to fight. And one of the things that we tell these ladies in Africa, because they were used to the men running, and I talked to them about this on my last trip, I said, ladies, I said, if the enemy comes, we will stand, we will fight, and we will die, but we will not surrender you to the wicked. You know, when God first called us to Africa, I never dreamed that I would do anything other than pastor, evangelize, and teach the Word of God. But when the rebels began to come and to kill women and children, I realized that we needed to do something to protect them. And I sat our guys down one day and I said, guys, I want you to understand something here. I go, it is not your job to save your life. It is your job to save their lives. We are men, they are women and children. If the enemy comes, not one of you guys is to pull off that line until we have evacuated every single woman and child. If you die, then you die. That is the role of a man. We are called to be protectors of women and children. We are called to care for those that cannot care for themselves. We know the tactic of the enemy. He comes with 200. He does not attack 200 soldiers. He attacks where there's 5 soldiers. They're cowards. They want to hit soft targets. They don't want to hit hard targets. So if one day there's 5 of us and they come with 200, just know this is the day that you're going to go home to meet the Lord. And see, we need to understand something. There is a code that men should live by. You know, in the times of past, we used to call it the Knight's Code. It was a code that men lived by. And folks, I want to read to you what was the Knight's Code. The Knight's Code: to serve the Lord in valor and faith, to protect the weak and the defenseless, to give refuge to the widows and orphans, to refrain from the giving of offense, to live by honor and for the glory of God, to obey those placed in authority, to guard the honor of your fellow knights, to keep faith, at all times to speak the truth, to respect the honor of women, never to refuse a challenge from an equal, and never to turn back from a foe.